The introduction paragraph is considered as the most important paragraph in your letter. There are two reasons for this. Firstly, this paragraph gives an overview of your letter to your examiner. അതായത് ഈ പാരഗ്രാഫ് വായിക്കുമ്പം നിങ്ങൾക്ക് എത്രമാത്രം കേസിലോട്ട് മനസ്സിലായെന്ന് നിങ്ങളുടെ എക്സാമിന് ക്ലിയർ ആവും. സെക്കൻഡ്ലി, യുവർ സ്ട്രെങ്ത് ആൻഡ് വീക്ക്നെസ് ഇൻ യുവർ ലാംഗ്വേജ് വിൽ ബി ഹൈലൈറ്റഡ് ഇൻ ദിസ് പാരഗ്രാഫ്. ദ നെക്സ്റ്റ് റീസൺ ഇസ് ദാറ്റ് യു ആർ ബീങ് മാർക്ക്ഡ് ഇൻ ദിസ് പാരഗ്രാഫ് ആൻഡ് ദ മാർക്ക്സ് ഗിവൻ ടു യു ഇൻ യുവർ ഇൻട്രൊഡക്ഷൻ പാരഗ്രാഫ് ക്യാൻ എഫക്ട് ദ ഓവറോൾ ഗ്രേഡ് ഓഫ് യുവർ ലെറ്റർ. ടു ബി ഫ്രാങ്ക്, ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് വെരി ഈസി ടു റൈറ്റ് ആൻ ഇൻട്രൊഡക്ഷൻ പാരഗ്രാഫ്. ഹൗഎവർ, ദർ ആർ ചലഞ്ചസ്. The most common challenges found among students are, firstly, not being flexible with the language. Secondly, selecting the wrong information. Let's talk about the information first. In order to write a very good introduction, you only need four information. That is, an opening phrase, name of a patient, then your purpose and reason. Well, let's learn about all these information in detail. Firstly, the opening phrase. Opening phrase is optional. You can include or you can avoid it. And there are a lot of different kinds of opening phrase. This letter is to refer. I am writing to refer. The purpose of this letter. However, the most commonly used opening phrase is I am writing. And it doesn't matter what kind of opening phrase you are using. You should show your flexibility. And the word coming after the opening phrase shows it. So, if you're writing a letter to refer, then you have to write, I am writing to refer. The next information is the patient's name. You can either use the full name or the surname of the patient. But OIT prefers full name because that is more used in the medical context. The next information is the most important information in the introduction. That is the purpose. Basically, purpose tells the reader your intention in writing this letter. You should only use general statements while you're writing the purpose. That means you have to use words like urgent assessment, further monitoring, ongoing care, and all this, instead of specific details. What do you mean by specific details? Well, basically, specific details tells the reader more detailed information. For example, monitor his vital signs every day. Educate him regarding his diet. Well, you can write this, but not in your introduction. You should only give general information over there. To strengthen the purpose, you have to add a justification point. And that is called the reason. Well, the mistake what most of the students make here is that they always think this should be a diagnosis. Well, that is wrong. It should be an information from a medical context. അതായത് you can either write a medical problem, a diagnosis, surgery, or other situations like transfer, discharge and all. So it need not always be a medical problem or a condition. So that's about the information. Now, let's check into the language. Well, according to OIT, the introduction paragraph should be written in plain, simple, clear language. The urgency should be mentioned and the purpose should be clear for your reader. That means you don't have to use any sort of advanced language or complicated structure in your introduction. So, in order to improve in your language, you should have a clear understanding on what you're writing. Develop your own style. You should understand the concept and try to implement your own idea. Well, I can give an example. Try to create a formula for your introduction paragraph. For example, the opening phrase plus patient name plus the reason or the purpose or vice versa. I'll give an example for this. I am writing to refer Mr. X, who has been diagnosed with pneumonia and requires continued care after discharge. Now, there is no rule that you have to first write the purpose or the and then the reason. It can be done either ways. You might have to change the structure when the why factor changes. That means, instead of refer, if you're putting request, you have to change the whole structure. Let's try this. Opening phrase plus why factor plus purpose, name of the patient, reason, purpose. Let's try. I am writing to request a home visit for Mr. X, who has been diagnosed pneumonia and requires further management. Next, so once you have mastered in creating the language, then you have to adapt your language according to the reader. Well, if your reader knows your patient, then the why factor should be update or in regard to. I'll give you an example on that. I am writing to update you regarding Mr. X, comma, a patient of yours, comma, who requires continued care after discharge. Or I am writing in regard to Mr. X, comma, a patient of yours, comma, who requires continued care after discharge. Now, if you're writing a letter to a reader who does not know the patient, change your language. I am writing to refer will be the first phrase. I am writing to refer Mr. X, who has been diagnosed with type 2 diabetes mellitus and requires continued care after his discharge today. Again, you have to be flexible according to the situation. Suppose you're writing a letter to a reader who has to take care of your patient after a surgery and the purpose is to provide rehabilitative care, you have to change your language accordingly. I am writing to refer Mr. X, who underwent a hip replacement surgery and requires rehabilitative care after his discharge today. Let's do another example. You're referring a patient who is suspected to have a disease condition and you want your reader to examine the patient as fast as possible. You can write it like this. I am writing to refer Mr. X, who is suspected to have pneumonia. He requires urgent assessment and management from your facility today. Now you can see how easy it is to write an introduction. Well, keep this in mind while you're writing your introduction. Remember, your first impression can be only made once. Thank you.